What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys.
And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as an open. I mean, it could very well have been our main event.
Introducing the challenger from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing in at 220 pounds, Jared! Introducing the champion from wherever he wants, weighing in at 208 pounds, he is the All-Star Universal Champion! The Blueprint, Isaiah!
Hope you're ready. The bell, and here we go. This is the type of battle that you can show someone who's new to our brand of entertainment and say, this is what WWE's all about.
These guys are undoubtedly going to give us a show here tonight.
Into the collar and elbow tie-up. Only one competitor comes out ahead here.
He's going for the pin.
And the champ kicks. facility.
Digging deep for a kick out.
Still too fresh. Up and knee drop. Jeez. Uh-oh. Slam down home. Not sure how much he has left.
Absolutely punishing.
Always nice when a boom.
The champ clearly getting the best of him here.
Oh, man, his chances are dwindling quickly. He's just taking on so much punishment.
But the question is,
this may very well be it. This guy's a competitor. He's not going down yet.
Not yet. A big fight feel. Pressure cooker situation. WWE Universe hanging on every move, looking for the finish.
No way. Oh, my goodness, what an impactful FTO.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you guys are. Your whole body hurts after a move. The history books will have to wait another day.
And here's another kick of the moves you saw in that match.
Big match for this young man. Oh my God, oh my God, no, out of the crowd. He doesn't even realize, from behind, an ambush. What an attack. I can't believe this, Corey.
Well, believe it, because it just happened. Trying to get the upper hand, and the bell rings. Here we go.
And we're all right.
Looking at these two men, I don't think there's going to be anything traditional about this one-on-one matchup.
And it looks to me like this entire arena is on its feet, and understandably so.
The devastating forearm stop.
Oh, he's got him up.
Boom! Spikes him down.
He's starting to feel it here. But he's very aware of who he's in there with and what he has to do to rebound.
Yeah, but it looks to me like he still has plenty of energy in that body of his. I wouldn't look too much into this right now.
I know it's early, but he has to do everything in his power not to let this get out of hand.
Oh, boy, he is winning.
He's got the shoulders down, and that was only a one. Too soon.
Just carrying the opposition here.
But you can't carry your opponent all day. You gotta make a move eventually.
Now, not He goes for the cover. Two. And how he survived that is anyone's guess.
Oh, man, I don't know who to root for.
He's already starting to tire.
I don't think this is how he envisioned this match going here tonight.
He's really starting to look fatigued here, guys. Your whole body starts to give up. He's going to need to be careful. In a back-and-forth match like this, he has to do everything in his power not to let his opponent gain too much momentum here.
This is going to be big, one way or another.
Look at this!
Putting it all on the line.
Looking for a repeat.
Damn, look to the body.
Wow, this is surprising you guys.
And you can put this singles match in the books.
These gentlemen get after it. Here are the highlights.
Twisted metal that we see as part of steel cages today dates back 80 years. To settle a dispute between competitors Jack Bloomfield and Count Pietro Rossi, the two met inside a ring surrounded by chicken wire. At first,
These types of matches are referred to as fence matches.
Ooh, what impact. Corey, you gave us an impressive history of the origins of the steel cage match. I'd like to point out to our viewers that from the 1960s to the mid-1980s, chain link fences were used to enclose the ring for WWE steel cage matches. A superstar could win by pinfall, submission, or by exiting the cage through the cage door or climbing over the top of the cage.
We should also point out, Michael, that the way to win a steel cage match can vary by match, depending on what was agreed to before contracts to compete in the match were signed. Talking about history, at WrestleMania 2, WWE unveiled the redesigned steel cage with solid steel blue bars before returning to chain link mesh in the late 1990s.
When this guy's on, look out. Ooh, nasty impact. Nailed it.
This might be it. Oh, my. You've got to believe this one's over.
His outlook is not good at all.
There's a certain feeling that comes over the combatants in a steel cage match once they hear the door close and see the official lock it. A superstar must know that their body is going to be thrown against the steel, that their face will most likely be raked across the cage, and that anything is legal in this environment.
What a way to win a singles match.
I can't believe what we just witnessed. Steel cage matches never fail to surprise and amaze.
Here is your winner, Maverick.
Extremely impressive win, guys.
That was simply a case of one guy determined to prove his dominance over another.
And that'll do it here for this one-on-one matchup.
Into the tie-up they go, but who's going to end up with the upper hand? Into the collar and elbow tie-up. Only one competitor comes out ahead here.
You gotta believe this one's over.
Suplex, but that's not all.
Into a ripcord lariat, what a combination!
Real quick, in case we have any newbies watching, a false count anywhere match means that this contest can literally end anywhere. Simple, right? Even Seth, you can understand the rules.
Shoulders on the mat. Two. To keep him down.
Just power out.
In describing this match, Corey, you said it can end anywhere, which means we could see this match conclude in the ring, the stands, the locker room.
It could even end outside the streets.
And on top of that, it's worth noting that anything is legal in this match, guys. The only rule is,
you might have it. Oh, incredible height.
Nice. Shut it down.
As he gets out of the submission.
But were we surprised, Michael? I did not see that one coming.
He's looking a little off balance. This is not where he wants to be right now, guys.
He has to be disappointed in this performance. He really is so much better than what he's shown so far.
Beautiful technique. Incredible.
His shoulders are down.
Oh boy, he is winning.
Here he goes, really working over the ball.
shoulders down. Is it enough? And there's the kick out.
Not yet.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Nasty impact.
Knee drop.
That was nasty. So precise. type is not on the line here, but I don't think the champ can afford to give less than a full effort.
Well, then I've got some good news for you, Cole, because there's a better chance of Saxton scoring a date for Friday night than there is with the champ giving less than 100%.
This should be an incredible matchup. I mean, both men have extensive offensive repertoires, lasting endurance, and an insatiable appetite to be number one.
Aside from Saxton's commentary, this has all the makings of an epic match.
This might be it!
Oh, my! Thank you.